The lies continue from the head down, with Bret Baier interviewing Donald Trump last night. Trump talking about the classified documents that were found at Mar-a-Lago.
The only way NARA could ever get this stuff, this back, would be please, 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 could we have it back?
And they
please.
Asked for that.
Because they have no, we
they
were
did
talking.
Ask for it.
No,
and they said, can you give
some,
the documents back?
And we were talking.
And then they said, they went to DOJ to subpoena you to get them
which
back.
They've never done before.
Right.
And
but why fairness, not just hand them over then?
Because I had boxes, I want to go through the boxes and get all my personal things out. I don't want to hand that over to NARA yet. And I was very busy, as you've sort of seen.
Yeah, but I've according to the indictment, you then tell this aide to move to other locations after telling your lawyers to say you'd fully complied with the subpoena when you hadn't.
But before I send boxes over, I have to take all of my things out. These boxes were interspersed with all sorts of things.
Interspersed with all sorts of things, Jake.
Oh boy. Okay, that's awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, we got him. or more accurately, he got himself. That was a confession.
Yeah, I mean, Jack Smith has to be looking at this saying, oh my God, this is good, right?
Yeah. No, if you're not a lawyer, you might be thinking, well, I don't know, it sounds like one of his normal BS excuses. You know, he wanted to get to send the documents later because he's worried about his golf pants that were in there, right? But no, wait, this is not about that. This is, he's going to go to court and there's a very specific charge against him, and he just admitted to the specifics of those charges. So he said, he admitted that he had the classified documents already, mental, like we know that he had them, right? But you shouldn't admit that. You should have your lawyer go, oh, he didn't know they were classified. He didn't know. He thought maybe they were all golf pants. There's like a million excuses you could have unless the moron client admits on national TV. But that's the small part. The large part is, so yeah, I didn't give him back. Oh my God, you just admitted it. That's a full blown confession. No, your lawyer could have done 1,000 things to prevent you from admitting that you purposely, with intent, did not give back the documents. Your weakest defense is, well, I had a good reason for breaking the law. I had a good reason for not returning it according to the law when I was supposed to return it. But there's a legal subpoena that you, even putting aside the records and how important the documents were, there's a subpoena saying, give us those documents. You must legally give them to us.
And he says, it's never been done before.
Right? Yeah.
So all he does when he's on the campaign trail is saying nobody's ever done anything like this before. But when it's being done to him, totally different, right?
Yeah.
You know, and Baier says that doesn't matter. That doesn't matter.
Yeah, that with so there's some other charges that he's charged with that he didn't directly confess to there, but a whole heap of them, including obstruction of justice, now is going to be incredibly simple to prove.
Right.
So but look, you can't fix stupid. You know, they used to have this thing with David Letterman at the end of the clips about his show, who would say, there's no off switch on genius, right? I always thought it was a little unbearable, but okay. With Trump, there's no off switch on idiot, okay? So he just goes up, verbal diarrhea, I did it.
And you wonder why lawyers keep quitting on this guy. Can you imagine if you were representing this guy and your client goes on TV and does this? I mean, it's incredible. He couldn't find a lawyer in Florida, you'll recall, last week for the arraignment itself. He couldn't find a Florida attorney. And this is exactly why, because he just goes out there. He continued, of course, and what he always does is compare himself to others. The unfair treatment he's getting, like a 7-year-old in the schoolyard. Here he's talking about the documents found at Mar-a-Lago, comparing them to the documents found at President Biden's home.
Everything was declassified because I had the right to declassify. You want to talk about a mess? Take a look at Biden, where he's got 1,850 boxes. He has boxes stored in Chinatown in D.C. He has boxes stored at Penn Center, and he has boxes under his Corvette and around his Corvette, sitting in a garage for years, where it was very seriously classified. Obama had it, Nixon had it, Carter had
Their
it. The Bushes
is that
had
these
it.
These are super sensitive national security documents.
Sure. I'm sure,
so here's,
I'm sure you'll see real super sensitive. That Biden has, because Biden has far more than anybody's ever kept.
And he turned them over when asked.
No, he didn't. He still hasn't given the 1,850 boxes that's stored at the University of Delaware. In fact, they're fighting them in court, and they're fighting them. And
but he opened up for them to look at it.
Excuse me, the boxes from Chinatown He didn't turn him over. He sent him up to his lawyer in Boston to look at before they handed him over.
And there are special counsel is looking at that, and we'll see what comes out of it. But I do want to just you can imagine. This. I don't want to dwell.
Man, he really hates China. Everything that he can blame on China, anytime he can stick China in there, he does it. But of course, a lot of what he just said, Cenk, is not true.
No, not at all. So look, at least he didn't say it this time, two different times. And we don't. Nobody even notes it anymore because everybody knows that Donald Trump is so over the top racist, it's not even an issue. Last two times he talked about the so-called boxes in Chinatown, he was like, and they don't even speak English there in Chinatown. That's absurd. Of course, Chinese Americans speak English, you moron, you bigoted fool. But okay, let's get back to the documents. So he says the 1850 boxes, not true, of course, right? Also not true that they don't speak English in Chinatown. Everything he says is not true. But the most important part of his lies there is Biden and Pence, when all this document stuff happened, went and on their own decided, hey, look, there's documents that we've sent to official places. That's some of which Trump mentions there, but he doesn't mention, no, they're guarded and they're official and they're supposed to be there, right? But they found some that weren't, including Pence, but they found it themselves. They did the search. And then they said, then they voluntarily handed them over. They weren't asked to hand, they just said, hey, look, we did a search and we found some too. And here we're sending them back to you. That is not a little different, that's massively different than the crime that Trump just admitted, which is the government says, hey, you have not like mementos and stuff that those other guys found. You have the biggest top secrets we have, including our nuclear secrets, our defenses, in a best case scenario, lying around Mar-a-Lago in a ballroom anybody can walk into, right? Give them back. And he goes, no, I'm not going to. I'm gonna look for my golf pants. I think he wasn't looking for his golf pants. I think he was looking for a giant check from a foreign country. But
certainly waiting for it. And even if he wasn't, the fact that he could have been is unbelievable. And it's like, if you find a wallet and you turn it in, you've done the right thing. For a while, you had that wallet and you shouldn't have had it. Perhaps it was somebody else's. I don't know. But that's what Trump, the argument Trump's making here. And then finally, there was this recording of Donald Trump waving a secret top secret document around. This is what the former president had said, Bret Baier.
According to the indictment, you were here at Bedminster on July 21st, 2021, after you're no longer president, and you were recorded saying that you had a document detailing a plan of attack on another country that was prepared by the US military for you when you were president, the Iran attack plan. You remember that?
Ready?
You were recorded.
It wasn't a document.
Okay.
I had lots of paper. I had copies of newspaper articles. I had copies of magazines.
I know. This is specifically a quote. You're quoted on the recording saying the document was secret, adding that you could have declassified it while you were president, but quote, now I can't. You know, this is still secret, highly confidential. And the indictment cites the recording and the testimony from people in the room saying you showed it to people there that day. So you say on this, on tape.
This is just the opposite.
That you can't declassify. So why have it?
What I said that I couldn't declassify it now, that's because I wasn't president. I never made any bones about that. When I'm not president, I can't declassify
that. That's what you said. You didn't declassify it.
I said, no. I said I couldn't
declassify it.
But that wasn't a document. Brett, there was no document. That was a massive amount of papers and everything else talking about Iran and other things. And it may have been held up or may not, but that was not a document. I didn't have a document per se.
There was no document. I was holding up papers. They were not documents. Donald Trump is desperate here. And again, Cenk, I think this is Exhibit B in Jack Smith's repertoire.
100%. Look, the one he was most dead to rights on is the one that they're talking about here, because he's on tape saying, here's a secret document that's highly classified. Now he's saying, it wasn't a document and it wasn't highly classified. It was newspapers or other papers. No one believes that, partly because he's on tape saying the exact opposite. Yeah, I mean, look.
And also acknowledging that he couldn't declassify it anymore, nodding his head there, because he wasn't president anymore and only the president can declassify these.
If he was a regular defendant, right now he'd be pleading to about 20 years. okay? And every lawyer would try to get him to just get only 20 years in prison, okay? So I know he's gonna try to get it, like if he wins the election, he just pardoned himself. If he loses the election, I wouldn't be surprised if a Democrat pardoned him. But that's the only thing that's gonna save him, because he's toast in court. Like before, a lot of talk about like, oh, they could get him, blah, blah, blah. No, he did it to himself. Absolutely, utterly toast.
And there'll be more cases and more potential pardons. This is not the end of the rope, end of the line.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.